about the water resources and the fortification in the Vijayanagara Empire. Now further we are going into the details of the urban core of the Vijayanagara Empire. So moving along the roads leading into the urban core, there is a relatively little archaeological evidence of the houses of ordinary people. Archaeologists have found fine Chinese porcelain in some areas, including in the northeastern corners of the urban core, and suggest that these areas may have been occupied by the rich traders. तो जो हमें urban जो urban core part है विजयनगर empire का, which basically lies in the northeastern part of विजयनगर empire, इसमें हमें देखते हैं कि ordinary लोगों की life से जुड़े हुए evidences बहुत कम मिले हैं, जिससे ये पता चलता है कि जो लोग थे वहाँ पे वो ज़्यादातर कौन रहते थे, द पीपल हु वर द रिच ट्रेडर्स, क्योंकि वहाँ पे चाइनीज प्रोसिलिन विच इज़ अ काइंड ऑफ चाइनीज सेरेमिक, वो उसके एविडेंसेस हमें वहाँ पर मिले हैं. ऑल्सो दिस वॉज ऑल्सो द मुस्लिम रेजिडेंशियल क्वार्टर, टॉम्स एंड मॉस्क लोकेटेड देयर हैव डिफरेंट फंक्शंस, येट देयर आर्किटेक्चर रिजेंबल दैट ऑफ मंडपास फाउंड इन द टेम्पल्स ऑफ हम्पी, विच बेसिकली gives us the idea that there was certain intermingling of the cultures there because the mosques were built in the Indian style. This is how the 16th century Portuguese traveler Barbosa described the houses of ordinary people there. According to him, the houses were built according to the occupation in long streets with many open places. And also field surveys indicate that the entire area was dotted with numerous shrines and small temples, which pointed the prevalence of a variety of cults in a particular area. Also, they have various, you know, water tanks and tanks in the temple so that they can feed the town dwellers as well. So this was the urban core, which basically formed the northeastern part of the Vijayanagara Empire. Now we are going to study about the royal center, which basically located in the southwestern part of the settlement. Although designated as a royal center, it included over 60 temples. The patronage of temples and cults was important for the rulers who were trying to establish their legitimacy and their authority over their subjects. So isliye temples banane us time pe bahut zaruri mana jata tha. About 30 building complexes have been identified as palaces. They are relatively large structures that do not seem to have associated with ritualistic functions. Apart from it, we have find some distinctive structures as well, which includes the Mahanavami Dibba and the audience hall. So because various buildings have been found, and one of the large building, it is basically designated as the royal residence. It has two impressive platforms, usually called the audience hall and the Mahanavami Dibba. So the audience hall is basically a high platform which have various pillars at a regular intervals, and it has a staircase going to the second floor. But before considering it as a, you know, designated to for a proper function, we have to further go into research. Later on, located on one of the highest platform in the city is the Mahanavami Dibba, a massive platform rising from a base of about 11,000 square foot to a height of 40 feet. This is evidence that it supported a wooden structure also on the above, because wood, it perishes with time. Time ke saath wood survive nahi kar paati hai, isliye hume jo iska baki ka structure hai wo nahi milta hai. But there were several, you know, rituals that were being associated with the Mahanavami Dibba. So Mahanavami, which basically means the great 9th day or the 10th day of the Hindu festival during the months of September and October, also known as Dashera, Durga Puja or Navratri in various parts of India. So this festival was basically organized on a very huge scale so that king can display their prestige and power. The ceremonies performed on this occasion included the worship of the image of the Lord, worship of state horses, and sacrifices of various animals. Dances, wrestling matches, and processions of the horses, elephants, chariots were also being carried, and this was the occasion on which the king used to inspect the army of the Naikas, and they used to pay tribute to the king as part of their loyalty. But was Mahanavami Dibba that stands today the center of elaborate ritual? It is actually confusing because Mahanavami Dibba ke aas paas jo area mila hai, according to some scholars, wo bahut chhota hai ki wahan pe itna bada function organize kara ja sakta ho us time pe. So therefore there is certain confusion regarding what for what purpose actually the Mahanavami Dibba was particularly used. Later on, other building include the Lotus Mahal, which was basically the council chambers, and also a very beautiful temple, Hazara Rama Temple, which basically depicts the stories from Ramayana, have also been found in the royal center. Further, we are going to read about the sacred center in our next class.